Good afternoon. Thank you. Hey, that's good. Well, let's try that again. Good afternoon. Yeah, boy, that really helped with her this morning, right? We're all energetic, right? Well, that's good news. Good news. Thank you for coming. It's good to have you here. Got a lot of things we want to cover today and some information we want to share. So we'll get to it. But before doing so, we want to acknowledge today. Today is a day on rather than a day off, as you know. We set this day aside to honor Martin Luther King Jr., and we do that in lots of ways. For those of you who were here last Saturday, we had a nice event here on campus, just a beautiful, beautiful event, lots of members from the community and press here, and one of the brightest moments of that evening, for me anyway, was seeing our Men of Merit and Sisters of Strength there. It was just very powerfully palpable for me to be sitting there in the office and or sitting there in the audience and the young men wearing the white shirts and the women wearing the dark shirts. It was just beautiful with Men of Merit and Sisters of Strength on it. And the clarion call they offered about the community helping the community be better, helping young men and women be better, let them have a vision, let them have hope for the future, and actually realizing MLK's promise to all of us and hope for all of us expressed in many different ways. And it was just really neat, and the applause, the standing ovation these young men and women got, and how they represent JCC throughout our community. So that was a particular point of pride. Special thanks to Amy Layton and also to Lee Hampton, just the great work that they have done in helping these young men and women realize about the promise, the hopefulness in our future. And in fact, that I like the quote here particularly, is really a promise of what is out there. It's not a promise for easy times. It's not a promise of absent challenge, but a promise of possibility, a promise of not only moving beyond civil rights issue, but working together, working collaboratively, and recognizing that there are many challenges that we do face. And that is, in large measure, one of the challenges that I face. I would like to be able to come before you one of these years, one of these semesters, and talk about something other than the challenges we face. But it is our lot, and it is our opportunity, it is our hope, and frankly, it is an honor for us to have the challenges before us as we work with people in our community, and to be able to deploy our best skills to be able to help them be successful. And so the theme today is going to be a lot about challenges that we face and helping others overcome them. And Amanda, I'll have you go to the next slide then. That's kind of the theme of our winter convocation. You know, it is challenging to me to find ways. It's challenging for all of us to find the ways that we can help people deal with the difficulties that they have in their life. I talked Saturday night about this very thing, but the fact that young men and women and non-traditional students as well come to us for lots of reasons, don't they? They come because they have lost a sense of hope. They're looking for something better. They want the better life. They want the dream. They want the possibilities that are out there, and they're looking for help in all kinds of ways. And we've got lots of media who are more than helpful to promote the negative. We have lots of people surrounding these individuals who may not necessarily be the most positive. That maybe they have never heard in their life that you are smart. You can be successful. Maybe they don't have the home life where the parents say you can be anything that you want to be. Most of us, if not all of us in this room, probably have had a life of privilege where we've had an education. We went to high school. We didn't drop out. We went to college. We have bread on the table. And others may not have that kind of nurturing environment, both spiritually, emotionally, physically, and in terms of their future potential. They might not have that. And so in many ways, we're very privileged. And these individuals who come to us in seeking help, they don't necessarily have that. And so the challenge they face is trying to build a life of hopefulness, being able to see the potential in the future while perhaps surrounded with negativity. It's perhaps they have the individuals in their life telling them that they cannot be successful. They will not go anywhere. They will not amount to anything. Perhaps they even have their own self-talk going on and that's incredibly destructive, where you can say to yourself, and you see our students do that, don't you? I can't do that. I don't know math. I'm not very good at English. I can't do that. I don't think that job is good enough for me. I just can't handle that, whatever it might be. And I've come to a point in life where I've recognized that it's easier to believe the bad stuff. Have you ever noticed that? It's easier to believe the bad stuff. And so we have to, by our very mission, we have to be the purveyors of hopefulness. We have to be the ones who erase the negativity in these people's lives and say, you are somebody. You can go places. You can be anything you want to be. And you know what? We're going to help you. And it doesn't matter what our station is here. It does not matter. It can be me. It can be any one of you. We can touch these lives in very simple but yet very profound ways. I've had students tell me very clearly that it was someone sweeping the halls in one building that turned their life around, who took a couple minutes to talk about how they're doing a good job, very proud about them coming to classes. They're sharing their personal stories. Small ways, big ways, doesn't matter your title. Each of us have that responsibility. And I think we should do so joyfully. I think we should take that on and embrace that as our opportunity to meet these challenges, meet the mountains head on, and help them journey on. You know, we've been doing this for a long time. Some of us have been here for years and years and years. I know we have some retirees coming up who have been here for decades. And for us, you know, it's kind of routine, isn't it? I mean, this is like seasons. They come and they go and they come and they go. But for those students, it's the first time, perhaps. Maybe the first time somebody said, I care about you. The first time that someone said, you can do this. The first time. And so they deserve our best every day. Every day we take on the mantle of helping people meet their challenge. We take on the mantle of making it fresh for everyone. Perhaps when we're tired or we're overworked or we're upset about something, to be able to put that aside and say, this is why I'm here. This young man, this woman, this returning worker, this displaced individual, this is why I'm here. And they're going to get my best every day. And that's hard. But we're going to do that together. We're going to face these challenges together, all of us here, so that we can better help the people around us. And that's kind of the theme of now what is kind of a tradition of a little message put to music here. So Amanda, if you will, we'll watch that, and then I'll be right back with you.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying.